Good afternoon, dear students. Welcome to all for today's social class. In previous class, we learned about biosphere, meaning of biosphere, meaning of ecology, and meaning of environment, and meaning of environmental pollution, along with air pollution also we learned. Today we will see water pollution. Water pollution is alteration in physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of water, which may have harmful effects on human and aquatic life, is called as water pollution. Got it? Aquatic life means marine organisms. Okay. The important sources of water pollution are natural: soil erosion, landslides, volcanic eruption, decay and decomposition of plants and animals, etc. These are considered as natural water pollutants. Okay. Let us see now man-made pollutants. Industrial effluents, urban waste, domestic waste, agricultural waste, thermal waste, oil spill, offshore drilling, nuclear waste, etc. These are considered as man-made water pollutants. Okay. Water pollution is different types: sea or ocean water pollution, groundwater pollution, river water pollution, lake pollution, etc. The water pollution has different types or kinds. What are that? Sea or what? Ocean water pollution, ground water pollution, river water pollution, lake pollution, etc. Okay. Let us see now the important effects of water pollution. What are the effects of water pollution? It spreads waterborne diseases and epidemics like cholera, typhoid, diarrhea, jaundice, etc. Got it? Causes death of aquatic life, the marine organisms also death due to water pollution. Affects irrigation water and on agricultural crops, nature and futures of water, etc. Now we'll see measures to control water pollution. How to control water pollution? See, industrial effluents must be treated. Drinking water sources must be kept clean. Sewage treatment means, sewage means drainage. Sewage treatment plants. Disposal of waste on the water bodies must be controlled, etc. Got it? Got it, dear students? How to control water pollution? Industrial effluent must be treated. Drinking water sources must be kept clean. Got it? Sewage treatment. Sewage means waste water or dirty water. Got it? Sewage treatment plants. Disposal of waste on the water bodies must be controlled, etc. Let us see now soil pollution. Soil pollution is decreases in the quality of soils either due to human sources or natural sources or by both. It is called as soil pollution. What do you mean by soil pollution? Soil pollution is decreases in the quality of soils either due to human sources or natural sources or by both. Both means human and natural sources. Got it? It results in the increase of soil erosion, lack of humus, decreases soil microorganisms, plants, nutrients, etc. Sources of soil pollution are industrial and mining waste, domestic and urban waste, agricultural waste, nuclear waste, etc. These are considered as pollutants of soil pollution. Got it? These are sources of soil pollution. Effects of soil pollution are: it decreases the fertility of the soil, converts the region into waterline. Got it, dear students? Let us see effects of soil pollution. It decreases the fertility of the soil. Got it? Converts the region into wasteland. Destroy the microorganisms in the soil, etc. Let us see now how to control soil pollution or measures to control soil pollution. Controlled and judicious use of chemical fertilizers, pesticides and insecticides, proper disposal of industrial and urban waste, proper use of land and crop management, awareness program on paper, soil utilization and its maintenance, etc. Got it? Let us see now noise pollution. Noise pollution is any undesirable sound dumped into the atmosphere leading to health hazards. What do you mean by noise pollution? Noise pollution is any undesirable sound dumped into the atmosphere leading to the health hazards. Got it? The important sources of noise pollution are natural, thunder, cyclone, heavy rainfall, hailstones, waterfalls, ocean waves, etc. These are considered as natural sources of noise pollution. Let us see now man-made noise pollution sources. Industrial noise, automobiles, automobile means vehicles, aircrafts, domestic noise, mining, etc. Mining means extraction of minerals from the earth is called as mining. Got it? Then effects of noise pollution. Noise pollution causes temporary or permanent hearing problem. Got it? Temporary or permanent hearing problem, headaches, restlessness, cardiovascular diseases, psychological disorder, behavioral changes, lack of concentration, etc. These are the effects of noise pollution. Okay, let us see measures to control noise pollution. How we will control noise pollution? Let us see now. Industries must be located away from the residential areas. Got it? First point, what? Industries must be located away from the residential areas. Construction of soundproof walls in the factories. Restricting unnecessary use of sirens, horns and loudspeakers. Airports must be located away from the residential zones. Zones means regions or areas. Okay. Protective instruments. The workers in the industries, noise producing vehicles must be checked, etc. These are the measures of controlling noise pollution. Got it? Now see global warming. The temperature of the earth is increasing slowly over the years. You know that, right? The temperature of the earth is increasing slowly years. Okay. Slowly over the years. For the last few years, global temperature has increased. This phenomenon is termed as global warming. Got it, dear students? What do you mean by global warming? The temperature of the earth is increasing slowly over the years. For the last few years, global temperature has increased. This is called as global warming. The warming of atmosphere is caused by greenhouse effect and trapping of heat by the atmosphere. The world is getting warmer. Warmer means getting temperature. Climatic zones are shifting, glaciers are melting and sea levels is rising due to global warming. Example, high rate of melting of ice in Himalayas, Arctic and Antarctic regions. Got it? Let us see now greenhouse effect. The energy that the earth receives from the sun has to be balanced by the radiation emitted from the earth's surface. The use of fossil fuels is increasing greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Got it? The use of fossil fuels. Due to this, the greenhouse gases is increasing atmosphere. Got it? Carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases trap the heat radiated from the earth. The increasing greenhouse gases is causing an increase of temperature. This is called greenhouse effect. Let us see now ozone depletion. Ozone is a thin layer of gas found in the stratosphere. Ozone is an thin layer. Where we will form this? We will form the ozone in stratosphere. Got it? Ozone absorbs ultraviolet rays and protects all forms of life on the Earth's surface. In recent years, the use of air conditioners, refrigerators, sprays and deodorants are destroying the ozone due to these synthetic chemicals released into the atmosphere, primarily chlorofluorocarbons, means CFCs. CFC stands for chlorofluorocarbons. Okay, the highest ozone depletion in the world is recorded in the atmosphere over Antarctica. Got it? The ozone depletion has caused the ozone hole. This has to be controlled for the sake of the people, of the present and the future generation. Got it, dear student? Let us see now acid rain. Acid rain contains high amounts of acids, particularly sulfuric acid and carbon monoxide. Got it? Acid rain contains high amounts of acids, especially sulfuric acid and carbon monoxide. It is caused when the raindrops passes through the polluted atmosphere. When causes acid rain? It is caused when the raindrops pass through the polluted atmosphere. That time we will be seeing acid rain. Okay. The rainfall with poisonous acids kill marine organisms. Acid rain is damaging forests, agricultural crops, old buildings, monuments, etc. Got it, dear students? Let us see. Acid rain is also referred to as lake killer. The acid rain is also called as lake killer. Got it? The black triangle stretching over Poland, Czech Republic and Southeast Germany is one of the worst acid rain affected regions in the world. What are the very worst or dangerous acid rain affected areas in the world? Poland, Czech Republic and Southeast Germany. Got it? Let us see now biodiversity. The variety of flora, flora means plants, and fauna, fauna means animals, in a region is known as biodiversity. Very simple, dear students. What do you mean by biodiversity? The variety of flora and fauna, or the variety of plants and animals in the region is known as biodiversity. Got it? Distribution of different kinds of plant and animal species in the region shows the richness of biodiversity. The maintenance of biodiversity is very important both for the quality of environment and also for human survival. The conservation of biodiversity is very important to save and protect rare plants and animal species. Providing good environmental condition for their living is the best means to protection. The Earth is the only living planet in our solar system. Got it, dear students? The Earth is the only living planet in our solar system. The way in which changes, disturbances, hazards are taking place on the Earth can lead to the destruction of the quality of life on our Earth is a near future. Let's see last para in this lesson. To save Earth and Mother Planet, we must educate people, formulate awareness programs, utilize the resources judiciously, control pollution awarenesses through education, symposium, seminars, skits, films, summits. These necessary to see our Mother Planet. Got it, dear students? I hope you clear today's topic. In case if you have any doubts, you can call at any time. I will clarify your doubts. Okay. Now homework is, see, first mind, 5 questions. Is a homework for you. Okay, dear students, write neatly in your homework book and send it in group. Okay, Thank you. Have a nice day. Thank you, one and all.